Here in the Schaefer's Oil Southern National Super Late Model Qualifying Heat Race event. And Chief Starter Dusty McDaniel showing the field the one to go signal will be coming to green next time by. Understand we're going 8 laps here in this one. Shannon Buckingham out of Morristown, Tennessee, and Kenny Collins out of Colbert, Georgia, with the field in tow. We'll bring them to the green flag here as they get ready to smash a loud pedal off turn number 4, and here we go. Drag race to turn 1. Who's going to come out of there with the top spot? Give it to Shannon Buckingham off of turn number 2. Put Kenny Collins in the second, Ben DeCastri third. As Rob May and Matt Henderson battle for the 4th spot. Buckingham going to lead them through on lap number 1 as Maya and Henderson continue to battle for the 4th position down into turns 1 and 2. Maya looks like he's going to come out of there with the position as Ben DeCastri challenges Kenny Collins for the bridesmaid spot off 4 down the front straightaway here at Crossville Speedway with 2 laps in the books. Buckingham continues to show the way. Collins second, DeCastri third, Maya fourth, Henderson fifth, then it is King, Heineman, Hedgecock. As Doherty did make the call. Skelton Walker and Doherty. DeCastri trying to work past Collins for the second position as Henderson's around Maya for the 4th spot as they race off turn 4 down the front straightaway with 4 laps scored, 4 to go. It is still Shannon Buckingham showing a way out in front. He's got about a half straightaway advantage back to second place running Kenny Collins, who battles with Ben DeCastri for that second position as Rob Maya and Matt Henderson go at it for the 4th spot. Laps winding down here now in this one. As Buckingham will work off turn number 4. Buckingham going to lead him down the back straightaway. He's got this one well in hand as they get set to roll off turn at number 4 to the white flag. 1 lap to settle it, and it's all Shannon Buckingham out in front. As Collins and DeCastri still battle for that second position. But off of turn number 4, your winner of the qualifying heat will be the 50 of Morristown, Tennessee, Shannon Buckingham. Second's going to be Kenny Collins in the 1C. Ben DeCastri going to finish in 3rd. Matt Henderson will be 4th, and Rob Maya will complete the top 5. So your podium finishers out of the Super Late Model qualifying heat, 3rd to 399 of Ben DeCastri, 2nd to 1C of Kenny Collins, and picking up the win. And that Longhorn Vicchio powered at Tennessee RV Super Center. RAV Vehicles for Life, Fleetwood RV sponsored entry out of Morristown, Tennessee, Crossville Speedway. Let him know you appreciate him. Give him a big round of applause, Shannon Buckingham. In the field, rolling around Crossville Speedway in the double file formation. And you see the field starting to break out into the 4 wide salute. Tier parking over on the back straightaway. Make some noise over there. Crossville Speedway on the back stretch at tier parking for your favorite driver. And wish him Godspeed for the next 35 laps here tonight in the Schaefer Oil A Main at Crossville Speedway. And Main straightaway, as they start to make their way into turns 3 and 4, we want you on your feet here at Crossville Speedway. All of you on your feet, wave your hands and caps in the air, wave those 4 wide rally towels as we got fireworks in the air. It's the Schaefer's Oil Southern Nationals presented by Sunoco Race Fuel and Tennessee RV Super Center here at Crossville Speedway. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, race fans, here they are. The fireworks in the air, but the fireworks now fixing to take place here around Crossville Speedway as the first 4 rows duck out of there. We'll let them spin a little heat in the tires here before we group them up and bring them to green. Caution light still on. We should see the one to go signal this time by. And Chief Trotter Dusty McDaniel showing them the one to go signal. Race fans, we're coming to green next time by. Brandon Overton and Donald McIntosh set to bring them to green. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls at Crossville Speedway, it's showtime. They drag race into turn number one. McIntosh goes up the banking. Overton got to jump out to the race lead here and try to lead them through on lap number one. The feature winner from Boyd Speedway back on Monday night. Vosbergen got to be second. McIntosh battling right back here with him. He goes to the bottom of Vosbergen. They're side by side for second while Shannon Buckingham rides in fourth. And Ben DeCastro battles with Billy Ogle Jr. for the fifth position. McIntosh fires the slider at Vosbergen, and he'll take third on lap number two. Overton with the lead. McIntosh in second. Vosbergen and Buckingham battling now for the third position. It's a workoff turn number two down the back straightaway here as we get ready to put lap number four up on the board. And on lap four, it looks like Buckingham's going to go into the third position. We'll come through and we'll have five laps complete this time as Overton sets sail out in front. He leads the way at a 1:16. McIntosh is second. Buckingham third, Vosbergen rides in fourth, and DeCastro, your final car in the top five at this point, as Billy Ogle Jr. and Kenny Collins go at it 4th, 6th, and 7th. Matt Henderson is eighth, Rob Mayer ninth, and Ryan King, the final car in the top 10. Brandon Overton continuing to lead the way here in this one. Working that machine down to complete yet another lap. He'll put lap number 7 up on the board. 7 down, 28 to go here tonight at Crossville Speedway. For Brandon Overton, he's a two-time winner with the series so far this season, with wins at Tri-County Racetrack and Boyd Speedway. And Overton about to start the process of working slower traffic here momentarily. As we slowly approach lap number 10, we'll have 9 complete this time, and it is all Brandon Overton out in front. Donald McIntosh rides in second. Shannon Buckingham third, Craig Vosbergen in a fourth, and Ben DeCastro in fifth. 2 Australians in the top 5 here right now. As Overton going to start the process of picking his way through traffic here with 10 laps in the books. 10 to down, 24 or 25 remain as we work lap number 11 here. Then we'll have 24 to go. Overton gets around the 83 of Jason Walker, and the next car he's going to have to negotiate will be the 25 of David Doherty. As Donald McIntosh continues to hold down the second position, Shannon Buckingham is third, Craig Vosbergen fourth, Ben DeCastro fifth, Billy Ogle Jr. 6th, Matt Henderson is in 7th. Kenny Collins 8th, Ryan King 9th, and Heath Hindeman is 10th. As Overton setting a torrid pace out in front here of this one. As we'll have a Baker's Dozen, 13 laps scored, 13 down, 22 to go here tonight at Crossville Speedway. And Overton looking good so far in this one, working the high side of the racing surface here at Crossville Speedway. McIntosh rides in second, and Buckingham starting to close on him a bit now from his third position. Vosbergen riding in fourth, and DeCastro is fifth. As Vosbergen trying to find a way to get back around Buckingham after losing that third position back on lap number 4, has been unsuccessful up to this point. Now Overton working off turn number 2 down the back straightaway. Has almost a full straightaway advantage over second place running Donald McIntosh. As Overton looking good in this one at this point. Overton comes down, he'll put another lap on the board. Looks like we got 17 complete, 18 remain, right around the halfway mark of this one. As we come by this time, we'll be halfway into your Shaper's Oil top 10. Got to be the Brandon Overton is the leader. Donald McIntosh second, Craig Vosbergen in third, Shannon Buckingham fourth, Ben DeCastro is fifth, Billy Ogle Jr. 6th, Matt Henderson is 7th, Ryan King in 8th, Heath Hindeman 9th, and Kenny Collins is 10th, the last car on the lead lap, and in danger of going a lap down here to race leader Brandon Overton at this point in the contest. Overton Going into turn three as McIntosh works off turn number two. He and Vosbergen working in heavy traffic there into turn number three as Nicastri is around Buckingham on the inside. Put Nicastri in the fourth, shuffle Buckingham back to fifth. So Buckingham losing a couple of positions as Vosbergen trying to close in on second place Donald McIntosh. But still unsuccessful. Looking for his second straight podium finish is Vosbergen. He finished second down at Boyd's on Monday night. And Brandon Overton out for a Thursday night drive beneath the stars here at Crossville Speedway tonight. As he'll work down off turn number four and complete lap number 24. This time by, there'll be 24 in the books, 11 remain. McIntosh second, Vosbergen third, Nicastri fourth. And Buckingham holding down the final spot in the top five, rides in fifth. With 10 to go for race leader Brandon Overton now. Overton. Only eight cars, I do believe, remain on the lead lap as he, Ryan King in the 1G and directly in front of him. The final car on the lead lap rides in the eighth position. In Overton, bringing that machine down to complete lap number 27. As McIntosh continues to hold second, Vosbergen is third, Nicastri fourth, Buckingham fifth. As we've got a lucky seven laps remaining, make it six now for race leader Brandon Overton as he goes off into turn number one. With this one well in hand, he enters turn number three as Donald McIntosh exits turn number two. Vosbergen holding down third. Nicastri is in fourth with Buckingham in fifth with less than five laps remaining now. Brandon Overton. That car with car owner Randy Weaver's won a lot of races here at Crossville Speedway. It's a former race winner here at Crossville with Weaver behind the wheel and Overton trying to etch his name in the record books with the Southern National Series and picking up a win at his car owner's hometown track here at Crossville Speedway tonight. He'll roll down three laps to go this time by for race leader Brandon Overton. Buckingham trying to work back beneath Castry. That's a battle for the fourth position. As that pair races off turn at number four down the front straightaway. And Buckingham going to claim that fourth spot here on lap number 32. Laps winding down here now in this one. As your leader working off turn number four, he's going to see the white flag. One lap to go here in this one tonight at Crossville Speedway. Overton takes that car down the back straightaway here at Crossville Speedway for the final time, working through turns three and off of turn number four. Evans, Georgia native Brandon Overton wins at Crossville Speedway. Second is going to be Donald McIntosh. Third will be Craig Vosbergen. Fourth, Shannon Buckingham. And fifth, Ben Nicastri.
Minutes and 3 seconds it took to run that race, ladies and gentlemen. Young man, congratulations. Your third feature event win of the 2017 season with the Schaefer's Oil Southern National Series presented by Sunoco Race Fuel and Tennessee RV Super Center. Young man, you left no doubt out there tonight. That 116 hot rod, pretty fast. Of course, back in the day when car owner Randy Weaver put it around this place, he won a lot of races here, and you just following in those footsteps. And, man, what a dominating performance out there tonight.
Yeah, that's right. I can't let him show me up, so we just give it our all every time we come over here. But I can't thank all my boys enough for working on this thing, Josh, Pearl, Vinny, Kirk. Like I said, it was definitely on the money tonight. That was probably one of the best cars I've ever had. Like I said, I can't thank all these fans and all for coming out on a Thursday night. You know, if it wasn't for y'all, I'd be flipping hamburgers or something. So we appreciate that. Hats off to the racetrack. It's pretty good. I'd like to just thank all my sponsors, Chip Stone, Randy Weaver. He's here with us. Got the boys from CrossFit Overton here. J.R. Rice Shocks, Andy Durham Race Engines, KB Carburetors, Outlaw Graphics. Who else? I think somebody else. Mission Transport, Henderson Motorsports. Sorry. But like I said, just we can't do it without everybody that helps us. And just thank y'all for coming.
You got to thank. You got the series points leader here right now. But I know you feel like you give two wins away on this deal. This is your third series victory. But I know you got to feel like that you may have let two slip away from you, one at Swainsboro and one at Screven. And if you'd have got them, you'd have been batting over 500 on this deal right now.
Yeah, you know, that's just how it goes. That's just racing. You know, you don't ever know when stuff can take a turn for the worse. But like I said, maybe we're back on track. We haven't had any bad luck. Our car's been fast the whole time. So, like I said, just hats off to all these guys that work on it and Randy and, you know, everybody that put this deal together. Like I said, I'm having fun. Just like keep racing.
Big round of applause. Brandon Overton wins at Crossville Speedway with the Shapers Oil Southern National Series. And we get our second-place finisher in here now, Donald McIntosh. Congratulations, young man. Great run for you and your race team here at Crossville Speedway tonight. But I know, man, you got to be getting tired looking at the rear spoiler of that 116 machine.
I'm pretty proud. I mean, the team that they are to run against, the guys that they normally run against, to come back and run, you know, we won three of these races. I don't think they were given to us, any of them. So I feel good. I mean, to be as good as we are, I can't thank these guys enough for staying behind me. He's a little better than we were tonight. We got two more nights, so.
That's right, two more nights left here in this points battle. The maneuverability of your race car, you look like right there, you talked about your piece being good. Brandon looked like he was pretty much committed to the top side of the racing surface, but it looked like you could take your car anywhere around the racetrack you needed to go.
I wasn't real comfortable on the top. That's where I felt like I needed to be to start with. And then they started telling me to get down. And I know Craig was catching me there. So when I got down, I know it helped me out some. I was more comfortable on the bottom. So, but, yeah, I'm real proud of this team. To win three races in this deal, and we're not giving up now. So I'm excited to go into the last two.
Big round of applause for our runner-up here tonight at Crossville Speedway, Donald McIntosh. And we get a quick word here now with our third-place finisher here at Crossville Speedway tonight, the defending winner of this event, Craig Weisbergen. And I know you got on Chris the other night and said, hey, I'm going to take all the time I want on here because I may not get back on the podium again. But, something about Crossville Speedway that suits you and your driving style, really good here again tonight. You come up a couple spots short, but I know you got to be proud of your race team coming home with a third-place finish.
Yeah, look, it was a really good result for us. I mean, I love this place. The fans are great. And, I mean, rain's been threatening, but look, all these guys and girls come out here tonight, and it's great to see. And, you know, they all come up to the trailer and
D-Mac just photobombed you right there.
So I love coming back here. And, of course, it was my first win in the States last year, and that makes it a bit special for me. But, yeah, it was a good result for the team. You know, third, we had two really quick guys in front of us, and I thought we had something for Donald there until he got some signals to move down the bottom, and that was pretty much it for me because we were pretty much married to where we were on the track there. The car wasn't moving around as well as I would like, but still had plenty of pace, so can't complain with a third-place finish.
That kind of led me into what was going to be my next question. It looked like you were pretty much set up to be around the bottom of the racetrack, and you really couldn't come off there, and maybe your car just not as maneuverable maybe as some of the other guys were to where you could come up and go to the top side of the racing surface.
Yeah, well, maybe I'm twice their age, and I'm not going to beat down the cushion all night. But, that's where we made a plan to run, and it pretty much worked out for us. I would have liked to get obviously the win, but I think we put up a pretty good show, and just like to thank my sponsors, Roger Sellers at Tennessee RV. He's always there when I need something, and he's just a great bloke to go with it. And Maxima Oils, FK Rod Ends, Hoosier Tire, all our product sponsors, and of course my great crew, Brent, my son, Kevin Rumley, Matt Crimmins has made the trip over from Australia, and Fonzie, you know, I've got a really dedicated crew. They take time off work to come and help me unpaid, and, you know, I can't thank them enough because I couldn't really do this deal without them. The Southern National Series for making me feel welcome, and of course, Crossville Speedway for putting on the show. And, I look forward to be back next year.
Big round of applause for our third-place finisher tonight at Crossville Speedway, Perth Western Australia's Craig Vosbergen.